What has Dory taught you over the years, and what can we learn from her?
Well, I think that everybody relates to Dory so much, or wants to relate to her, because she's so optimistic. And because she has this supposed disability, she doesn't really worry about the past or try to analyze the future, and it doesn't paralyze her to make decisions. She's just spontaneous, and she's non-judgmental, and she's, no matter what mood somebody else is in, it doesn't impact her. She doesn't take it personally. So I think it's basically, you know, it reminds me, and which is what I try to do every day and say on the show, is be kind to one another. I think that's what Dory does. And the whole just keep swimming from the very first one that it's attached to my fish's character is sort of a wonderful mantra that I think that really I didn't know I had most of my life and most of my career, but I have applied it to my life, and I think a lot of people apply it to their lives. I think it's an important message, as Andrew said, that this supposed disability that she has is her strength. And I think that we all have to look for whatever it is about us that we feel is our disability, whether it's physical or mental, and look at it as what makes us special and makes us unique, and use that to empower us. Yeah, I mean, obviously, the story is the journey of where are her parents, I mean, and what happened to her, and how did she get separated from them. So she's looking for, out of what any child would do, is who's my mother and father, where are they? But I think that it's not about a mother and a father, and it's not about blood relations. It's about who makes you feel good, and who gets you and supports you for all of who you are. And that's, to me, what family and what home is wherever you're supported.
Yeah.